It's often been said that good writing and character development has a character in a different place from when he began.
This is the case for Ray Kroc, who starts out as an over-the-hill milkshake mixer salesman that you feel sorry for, to becoming the founding member of the McDonald's Corporation and hating him at the end of it. The thing that is most rewarding about this movie is not just seeing the end result of Kroc getting what he wants, but it's the progression of how the McDonald's system works to finding loopholes within the contract to where he is able to acquire more capital, putting the McDonald brothers out of their purview. The contract between the brothers and Kroc is simple. He is given 1% of the revenue from the franchisee's profit, and he has to stick to the agreements that all changes to the Speedy system or architectural changes have to be agreed with them. This, of course, as you can imagine, has Ray feeling frustrated because he can see the ideas when presented to him can make a difference to running costs and requiring more money to open up more franchises, but the brothers are more than content at a slow-paced progression and not wanting to be greedy.
The game changes when Harry J. Sonnemore, a financial consultant who is an admirer of Ray Kroc's establishment, highlights to him that the real money is in real estate and not off a 15-cent hamburger.
This comes at a much-needed point for Ray, as he was on the point of bankruptcy as he had remortgaged his own home in order to acquire the capital. What is interesting is seeing the different perspectives of the characters from Ray, Mac, Ray's estranged wife, Ethel, and Joan, who Ray seems to be smitten with even though she's married to one of his franchisees in Raleigh Smith.
As much as you understand Ray's work ethic and his desire to be the best, you also sympathize with the brothers as he's taking their creation and making business decisions that they don't agree with.
Except it's not a change.
Excuse me?
It's not a change. It's a company. It's its own separate company, which puts it outside your purview.
Anything relating to McDonald's is within our purview.
Let me explain something to you, Dick. You boys have full say over what goes on inside the restaurants. But outside, above, below, your authority stops at the door and at the floor. All right?
And Ethel for not being consulted for having their home remortgaged, and Joan wanting to see Ray succeed.
What makes you hate Ray at the end of the movie after having acquired the name of McDonald's from the brothers so that he could take the business to new heights is the fact he lays down signs of a new McDonald's that he advertises to be built across the road after they renamed their restaurant McDonald's No. 1 to the Big M.
It's a well-written story chronicling the history of how McDonald's became a corporation.
What is there to say? It's Michael Keaton. He is a great chameleon actor that once he starts researching a role, he commits to the bit. From playing Bruce Wayne Batman to Birdman and now as Ray Kroc, the real-life figure who took McDonald's to new heights. Michael is able to recognize Kroc's speech pattern, cadence, and the way he would clip when speaking. Keaton is able to have you feeling sympathy for Kroc in the beginning, cheering him when he begins succeeding and then jeering him to when he makes his heel turn, screwing the brothers out of their creation.
Nick gives a decent performance as a guy with dry wit, as a no-nonsense businessman, as Dick McDonald. John has wonderful energy as Mac McDonald, and he really displays the enthusiasm about his older brother's idea of going national finally being realized.
It's been a while since we've seen this actress as Velma in the Scooby-Doo movies, and this was only a year removed from when she played the wife of Hawkeye in Avengers 2, Age of Ultron. For the small role she has as Joan Smith, who becomes Ray Kroc's third and final wife, she plays the forbidden fruit that Ray couldn't have as the wife of Raleigh Smith. Novak is a good supporting player, acting as the man who turns things around for Ray Kroc. He gives a great performance with smooth delivery of his lines.
You don't build an empire off a 1.4% cut of a 15-cent hamburger. You build it by owning the land upon which that burger is cooked. What you ought to be doing is buying up plots of land, then turning around and leasing said plots to franchisees, who, as a condition of their deal, should be permitted to lease from you and you alone. This will provide you with two things. One, a steady upfront revenue stream. Money flows in before the first stake is in the ground. Two, greater capital for expansion, which in turn fuels further land acquisition, which in turn fuels further expansion, and so on, and so on.
And it's also worth noting, he played Alistair Smythe in The Amazing Spider-Man 2. I just want to say that Laura's performance is criminally underused in this movie as the estranged wife of Ray Kroc, who criticizes a lot of his choices in the movie. We know that Laura's performances from movies like Damage with Mickey Rourke and her involvement with the Jurassic Park series, she knows how to produce the goods. In this, she isn't given enough to show what she can really do. Carter Burwell, whose credits include 1991's Doc Hollywood, Mr. Holmes, No Country for Old Men, Three Kings, The Big Lebowski, and A Goofy Movie, takes on the role of composer and he really gives this movie character. From when you see Kroc crossing America to get to San Bernardino to McDonald's number one and to people enjoying a freshly cooked McDonald's hamburger and the sheer delight on the look of people's faces as the joy is enhanced by his masterful pieces.
The same could be said when you see Kroc recruiting new employees and you hear these wonderfully uplifting rising pieces that actually make you want to be part of his vision of McDonald's for the future.
This is continued to when Sonnenfeld gets Kroc to see what he can do with more real estate capital.
Also, the duet of Pennies from Heaven by Michael and Linda is just wonderful.
Trade them for a package of sunshine and flowers. If you want the things you love, must have showers.
Going to the Spirit in the Sky by Norman Greenbaum is a nice touch as it shows what transpired by the real Ray Kroc and the progression of McDonald's since the 60s. The movie grossed a profit of $24.1 million against a budget of $7 to $25 million, and it earned a further $2.5 million through domestic video sales, bringing its overall profit to $26.6 million. Put in 5 years of inflation, and its total now would be $29.3 million. Despite its modest earnings at the box office and home releases, it did score favorable reviews. Rotten Tomatoes' consensus of the movie states, "The founder puts Michael Keaton's magnetic performance at the center of a smart, satisfying biopic that traces the rise of one of America's most influential businessmen and the birth of one of its most far-reaching industries." Rolling Stone magazine's Peter Travers had this to say after giving it 3 out of 4 stars, "Strive hard and mostly succeed at keeping Hollywood's sentiment out of the storytelling. Set more than half a century ago, The Founder proves to be a movie for a divisive here and now. Set right up, you might just learn something." Michael Keaton won the 2016 Capri Award for Best Actor. Personally, I think he should have gotten an Oscar for his performance. I think it's one of those movies that had a great story to tell but ended up being unappreciated for what it was. What most consider as probably the best real estate story.
The movie has been enjoyed on DVD and Blu-ray since 2016. I'm MJ Knight, and we learnt the history of McDonald's with The Founder. You know, it's often been said that good writing and character development has a... That's the vanilla cola talking. There's a blooper. Also, the duet of Pennies from Heaven by Michael and Linda is just wonderful. It's also available on Amazon MP3. Go download it. Seriously, you won't regret it. Leave that as an outtake. The movie has been enjoyed on DVD and Blu-ray since 2016. I'm MJ Knight, and we've learned... Hey, Doc. How did I get to McDonald's? Rabbit! You're in the wrong place. McWabbits? Don't give him ideas. We don't want to see carrot burgers and carrot milk. Carrot milkshakes. Ugh, that sounds revolting. Ugh. Bucky O'Hare might like the idea of that, but me, I like my strawberries, vanilla, strawberry, chocolate. Cookie dough. I know Raiden's salivating at that. Go mop up, dude. Just saying. Or even pistachio, but carrot milkshakes? Mm-mm. No. Okay,